All right.
Let us begin. Let's see what we have.
The best of the mages are ready, Herald. Be certain you are prepared for the assault on the breach. We cannot know how you will be affected.
Focus past the Herald. Let her will draw from you.
Solas confirms the heavens are scarred but calm. The breach is sealed. We've reports of lingering rifts, and many questions remain. But this was a victory. Word of your heroism has spread.
You know how many were involved. Luck put me at the center.
A strange kind of luck. I'm not sure if we need more or less. But you're right. This was a victory of Alliance, one of the few in recent memory. With the breach closed, that Alliance will need new focus.
Forces approaching! To arms!
What the? We must get to the gates!
I knew it was too easy.
We have to put up barricades or something.
Cullen?
One watchguard reporting. It's a massive force, the bulk over the mountain.
Under what banner?
None.
None?
I can't come in unless you open.
I'm Cole. I came to warn you, to help. People are coming to hurt you. You probably already know.
What is this? What's going on?
The Templars come to kill you.
Templars? Is this the Order's response to our talks with the mages, attacking blindly?
The Red Templars went to the Elder One. You know him? He knows you. You took his mages. There.
I know that man. This Elder One.
Very angry that you took his mages.
Cullen, give me a plan. Anything.
Haven is no fortress. If we are to withstand this monster, we must control the battle. Get out there and hit that force. Use everything you can.
Mages! You! You have sanction to engage them. That is Samson. He will not make it easy. Inquisition! With the Herald! For your life! For all of us!
Firing. coming. Keep them off the trebuchet.
Possible.
Everyone to the gates!
Back to the Chantry. It's the only building that might hold against that beast.
At this point, just make them work for it.
Haven must evacuate to the Chantry!
about time.
Here, survivor!
Harold! What's happening? Maker, thank you. Thank you!
Our lady is with us. Thank you.
A survivor!
I believe that is everyone. Best to follow. Is your shelter.
He tried to stop a Templar. The blade went deep. He's going to die.
What a charming boy.
Harold, our position is not good. That dragon stole back any time you might have earned us.
I've seen an archdemon. I was in the Fade, but it looked like that.
I don't care what it looks like. It's cut a path for that army. They'll kill everyone in Haven.
The Elder One doesn't care about the village. He only wants the Herald.
If you know why he wants me, just say it.
I don't. He's too loud. It hurts to hear him. He wants to kill you. No one else matters, but he'll crush them, kill them anyway. I don't like him.
You don't like... Harold, there are no tactics to make this survivable. The only thing that slowed them was the avalanche. We could turn the remaining trebuchets, cause one last slide.
We're overrun. To hit the enemy, we'd bury Haven.
We're dying, but we can decide how. Many don't get that choice.
Yes, that. Chancellor Roderick can help. He wants to say it before he dies.
There is a path. You wouldn't know it unless you'd made the summer pilgrimage, as I have. The people can escape. She must have shown me. Andraste must have shown me so I could tell you.
What are you on about, Roderick?
It was whim that I walked the path. I did not mean to start. It was overgrown. Now, with so many in the Conclave dead, to be the only one who remembers... I don't know, Harold. If this simple memory can save us, this could be more than mere accident. You could be more.
If that thing is here for me, I'll make him fight for it.
And when the mountain falls, what about you? Perhaps you will surprise it, find a way. Inquisition, follow Chancellor Roderick through the Chantry. Move!
Harold, if you are meant for this, if the Inquisition is meant for this, I pray for you.
They'll load the trebuchets. Keep the Elder One's attention until we're above the tree line. If we are to have a chance, if you are to have a chance, let that thing hear you.
We will exact a heavy price. They will not take us easily.
Thank you.
They must be aimed quickly.
Coming our way. We'll be right back.
Move! Now!
Pretender, you toy with forces beyond your ken no more.
What are you? Why are you doing this?
Mortals beg for truth they cannot have. It is beyond what you are, what I was. Know me. Know what you have pretended to be. Exalt the Elder One. The will that is Corypheus. You will kneel.
You're forcing this fight for no reason.
You will resist. You will always resist. It matters not. I am here to anchor. The process of removing it begins now. It is your fault, Herald. You interrupted a ritual years in the planning, and instead of dying, you stole its purpose. I do not know how you survived, but what marks you as touched, what you flail at rifts, I crafted to assault the very heavens. And you used the anchor to undo my work. The gore.
Why did the Divine die? For this chaos?
The chaos will empower me and ensure we no longer beg at the feet of the invisible. I once breached the Fade in the name of another to serve the old gods of the Empire in person. I found only chaos and corruption, dead whispers. For 1,000 years I was confused, no more. I have gathered the will to return under no name but my own, to champion Wither Tevinter and correct this blighted world. Beg that I succeed, for I have seen the throne of the gods, and it was empty. The anchor is permanent. You have spoilt it with your stumbling. So be it. I will begin again. Find another way to give this world the nation and God it requires. I will not suffer even an unknowing rival. You must die.
You expect us to surrender and kneel. We will not. You'll face us all when we choose.
down!
Thank you.
recent. Thank the Maker!
What would you have me tell them? This isn't what we asked them to do.
We cannot simply ignore this. We must find a way.
And who put you in charge? We need a consensus or we have nothing.
Please, we must use reason. Without the infrastructure of the Inquisition, we're hobbled.
I can't come from nowhere.
She didn't say it could.
Enough! This is getting us nowhere.
Well, we're agreed on that much.
Shh. You need rest. They've been at it for hours. They have that luxury thanks to you. The enemy could not follow. And with time to doubt, we turn to blame. Infighting may threaten as much as this Corypheus.
Do we know where Corypheus and his forces are?
We are not sure where we are, which may be why, despite the numbers he still commands, there is no sign of him. That, or you are believed dead. Or without Haven, we are thought helpless. Or he girds for another attack. I cannot claim to know the mind of that creature, only his effect on us.
If they're arguing about what we do next, I need to be there.
Another heated voice won't help, even yours, perhaps especially yours. Our leaders struggle because of what we survivors witnessed. We saw our defender stand and fall. And now we have seen her return. The more the enemy is beyond us, the more miraculous your actions appear, and the more our trials seem ordained. That is hard to accept, no? What we have been called to endure? What we perhaps must come to believe?
I escaped the avalanche. Barely, perhaps, but I didn't die.
Of course, and the dead cannot return from across the veil. But the people know what they saw, or perhaps what they needed to see. The Maker works both in the moment and in how it is remembered. Can we truly know the heavens are not with us?
You saw Corypheus. What do you think of his claims of assaulting the heavens?
Scripture says magisters, Tevinter servants of false old gods, entered the Fade to reach the Golden City, seat of the Maker. For their crime, they were cast out as darkspawn. Their hubris is why we suffer blight, and why the Maker turned from us. If such is the claim of this Corypheus, he is a monster beyond imagining. All mankind continues to suffer for that sin. If even a shred of it is true, all the more reason Andraste would choose someone to rise against him.
Corypheus said he found only corruption and emptiness, nothing golden.
If he entered that place, it has changed him without and within. The living are not meant to make that journey. Perhaps these are lies he must tell himself, rather than accept that he earned the scorn of the Maker. I know I could not bear such.
Mother Giselle, I just don't see how what I believe matters.
Lies or not, Corypheus is a real physical threat. We can't match that with hope alone. More than an enemy. It needs a cause.
A word. A wise woman, worth heeding. Her kind understand the moments that unify a cause, or fracture it. The orb Corypheus carried, the power he used against you, it is Elven. Corypheus used the orb to open the breach. Unlocking it must have caused the explosion that destroyed the Conclave. I do not yet know how Corypheus survived, nor am I certain how people will react when they learn of the orb's origin.
All right. What is it, and how do you know about it?
They were foci, used to channel ancient magics. I have seen such things in the Fade, old memories of older magic. Corypheus may think it, Devinter. His empire's magic was built on the bones of my people. Knowing or not, he risks our alliance. I cannot allow it.
This whole mess is confusing. I can see how elves might be an easy target.
History would agree. But there are steps we can take to prevent such a distraction. By attacking the Inquisition, Corypheus has changed it. Changed you. Scout to the north. Be their guide. There is a place that waits for a force to hold it. There is a place where the Inquisition can build, grow.
We'll be right back.
They arrive daily from every settlement in the region. Skyhold is becoming a pilgrimage. If word has reached these people, it will have reached the Elder One. We have the walls and numbers to put up a fight here, but this threat is far beyond the war we anticipated. But we now know what allowed you to stand against Corypheus. What drew him to you?
He came for this, and now it's useless to him, so he wants me dead. That's it.
The anchor has power, but it's not why you're still standing here. Your decisions let us heal the sky. Your determination brought us out of Haven. You are the creature's rival because of what you did. And we know it. All of us. The Inquisition requires a leader. The one who has already been leading it. You.
I don't know what to say.
Say that you will not make me regret this.
If you're not sure, why do it?
Because I believe this is what was meant to be. That without you, there would be no Inquisition. What it means for the future, how you lead us, that is entirely up to you.
This isn't about a greater message. We have an enemy, and we have to stand together. We'll do what is right. The Inquisition will fight for all of us.
Wherever you lead us.
Have our people been told?
They have. And soon, the world.
Commander, will they follow?
Inquisition, will you follow? Will you fight? Your leader, your herald, your inquisitor!
So this is where it begins.
It began in the courtyard. This is where we turned that promise into action.
But what do we do? We know nothing about this Corypheus except that he wanted your mark.
Corypheus wants to restore Tevinter. Is this a prelude to war with the Imperium?
I get the feeling we're dealing with extremists, not the vanguard of a true invasion.
Tevinter is not the Imperium of 1,000 years ago. What Corypheus yearns to restore no longer exists.
Though they would shed no tears if the South fell to chaos, I'm certain.
Could his dragon really be an archdemon? What would that mean?
It would mean the beginning of another blight.
We've seen no darkspawn other than Corypheus himself. Perhaps it's not an archdemon at all, but something different?
Whatever it is, it's dangerous. Commanding such a creature gives Corypheus an advantage we can't ignore.
Corypheus said he wanted to enter the Black City, that this would make him a god.
He is willing to tear this world apart to reach the next. It won't matter if he's wrong.
What if he's not wrong? If he finds some other way into the Fade?
Then he gains the power he seeks, or unleashes catastrophe on us all.
Someone out there must know something about Corypheus.
Unless they saw him on the field, most will not believe he even exists.
We do have one advantage. We know what Corypheus intends to do next. In that strange future you experienced, Empress Selene had been assassinated.
Imagine the chaos her death would cause. With his army.
An army he'll bolster with a massive force of demons, or so the future tells us.
Corypheus could conquer the entire south of Thedas, god or no god.
I'd feel better if we knew more about what we were dealing with.
I know someone who can help with that. Everyone acting all inspirational jogged my memory, so I sent a message to an old friend. He's crossed paths with Corypheus before and may know more about what he's doing. He can help.
I'm always looking for new allies. Introduce me.
Parading around might cause a fuss. It's better for you to meet privately, on the battlements. Trust me, it's complicated.
Well, then, we stand ready to move on both of these concerns.
On your order, Inquisitor.
I know one thing. If Varric has brought who I think he has, Cassandra is going to kill him.
This is the Inquisition. A dusty old ruin filled with battered soldiers.
If you shut your mouth and open your eyes, you'd see that the Inquisition is our one hope.
I've made some inquiries into the Imperial Court. The sooner we deal with the threats to the Empress, the better. The political situation in the Empire is dangerously unstable. It will complicate matters.
Everything in the Empire complicates matters. It's the Orlesian national pastime.
Turn your nose up at the grand game if you like, Commander, but we play for the highest stakes, and to the death.
The Court's disapproval can be as great a threat as the Venatori. We must be vigilant to avert disaster.
Exactly what do you mean? How is it more dangerous than usual?
The Empress is in the middle of a civil war. Her cousin, Grand Duke Gaspard, seeks to take her throne by force. Leliana reports that a group of elves has been sabotaging both armies, drawing out the hostilities. Orle holds Tevinter at bay. All of Thedas could be lost if the Empire falls to Corypheus. Selene is holding peace talks under the auspices of a grand masquerade. Every power in Orle will be there. It's the perfect place for an assassin to hide.
We need to attend this ball.
I'll arrange for an invitation at your discretion, Inquisitor.
was this place? So much room for whatever was here.
Sister Leliana will want access to the birds. Get the cages up here. Quickly.
Majestic. How is a place like this ever lost?
Inquisitor,
meet Hawk,
the champion of Kirkwall.
Though I don't use that title much anymore.
Hawk, the Inquisitor. I figured you might have some friendly advice about Corypheus. You and I did fight him, after all.
This view reminds me of my home in Kirkwall. I had a balcony that overlooked the whole city. I loved it at first, but after a while, all I could see were the people out there depending on me.
You're lucky it was just a single city. I've got half of Thedas.
You're doing everything you can to protect them.
Does it ever get any easier?
I'll let you know. I don't envy you, Inquisitor. but I may be able to help you.
Varric said that you fought Corypheus before.
Fought and killed. The Grey Wardens were holding him, and he somehow used his connection to the Darkspawn to influence them.
Corypheus got into their heads, messed with their minds, turned them against each other.
If the Wardens have disappeared, they could have fallen under his control again.
If that's what happened to the Wardens, do you think we can free them?
It's possible. But we need to know more first. I've got a friend in the Wardens. He was investigating something unrelated for me. His name is Stroud. The last time we spoke, he was worried about corruption in the Warden ranks. Since then, nothing.
Corypheus would certainly qualify as corruption in the ranks. Did your friend disappear with them?
No. He told me he'd be hiding in an old smuggler's cave near Crestwood.
If you didn't know about Corypheus, what were you doing with the Wardens?
The Templars in Kirkwall were using a strange form of lyrium. It was red. I'd hoped the Wardens could tell me more about it.
Corypheus had Templars with him at Haven. They looked like they'd been exposed to the lyrium you describe.
Hopefully my friend in the Wardens will know more.
I appreciate the help.
I'm doing this as much for myself as for you. Corypheus is my responsibility. I thought I'd killed him before. This time, I'll make sure of it. Inquisitor.
I heard you had family and friends in Kirkwall. Where are they now?
When the Wardens began acting strangely, I had my friend Aveline take my brother out of the Free Marches. My uncle Gamlin's still in Kirkwall. But everyone else I used to know? They've pretty much scattered to the winds.
I assume Varric's been feeding you information about the Inquisition. What did he say about me?
Only good things, I promise. I was a little surprised, actually. Varric isn't one for religion in general, but he thinks highly of the Inquisition. I think the exact phrase was, has a good shot at fixing Blondie's mess.
You said you thought you killed Corypheus.
The Grey Wardens had him imprisoned. They used my father's blood in a ritual to seal Corypheus inside, but he could still reach out and influence the Wardens' thoughts. He sent them after me, and I didn't just think I killed him. When the fight was done, he was dead on the ground. Maybe his tie to the Blight somehow brought him back. Or maybe it's old Tevinter magic. But he was dead. I swear it.
Where did you go after the mages rebelled?
I heard the Chantry might be sending an exalted march to Kirkwall to put down the rebellion. I hoped that leaving would save lives and force the Divine to divide her forces to come after me. As it turned out, I needn't have bothered. All the circles started rising up, and the exalted march never came.
I'd like to know more about Anders. What was he like?
I don't know if there ever was just an Anders. He was crazy. By the end, there was nothing left in him except this insane need to start a war no one could win.
We'll talk later.
I'll meet you at Crestwood.